And that's what he's doing. So, you know, we're just working, man. And it's just trying to get the best fights out there.
Let me pick your boxing brain now and get some fight predictions. How do you see that fight going, Canelo, Triple G?
You know, I think a lot of people are going with Canelo just because they think Triple G is kind of slipping. I don't see him slipping at all. I think he just get bored in the fights when things are just going his way all the time. He gets so bored when the other guys don't want to fight. But, you know, I like Triple G. As a boxing fan, I really like Triple G. I think he's a smart guy. You know, he knows the ins and out of the ring. You know, Canelo is the younger guy. He has probably more fights than Triple G does. But I think Triple G is going to win. I think Canelo is going to stand right in front of him, and he's going to knock him out.
Oh, wow. So you think the odd makers have this fight right? Because Triple G is kind of like the heavy favorite against Canelo.
Well, I mean, that's as far as the boxing community is concerned. Mm-hmm. But as far as the fans are concerned, they think Triple G is slipping.
That's true. Yeah, they're saying, and, you know,
yeah,
he's
a lot of
maybe
people saying
his
he's
age.
Slipping. Yeah, absolutely. I don't see it.
What do you think about, you know, Floyd Mayweather and all these guys saying that they think Canelo's going to stop Triple G? Do you see that as a realistic option? I mean, he's never even been down his whole amateur career.
Well, I know being in sports for so long that it's a possibility that could happen. Because, look, Canelo has the power to do that. But on the flip side, so does Triple G. Mm. And I think people really slack on his defense. The man has good defensive skills. And sometimes he stops and he gets so bored, let a man hit him just to get him close to him so he can knock him out. And that's what he does.
You're not maybe being a little biased because you want Charlo to give him his first loss, are you?
No, I want Charlo to beat both of them.
Okay.
You know? I mean, we want to get both of them.
So you don't care who wins as long as you get a shot at one of them, right?
That's right. That's our only thing. You know, right now it's going to be harder to get Canelo because he don't want to fight for the WBC. Mm. You know, he got a thing with them, against them, and... You know, he don't want to fight for it, but Jose Suleiman say he go make it for the WBC anyway. But, you know, look, either he go fight or he not going to fight. It don't have to be for the WBC title. We don't need it. Fight Jermall Charlo.
Now, I've got to ask you about this because it's the hottest topic going around. Conor McGregor, Floyd Mayweather. You're a true boxing purist. How do you feel about it? What are your thoughts?
Look, you know, Conor McGregor is a guy in the MMA. Mm-hmm. Or UFC, whatever it is. I don't watch it. Mm-hmm. But, you know, look, Floyd Mayweather is going up to 154 pounds. You know, he's only fought up there once. And, you know, I think McGregor's going to be the stronger guy in the fight. He's going to give Floyd some problems early just because Floyd is not in a rush to figure him out. Floyd is going to take his time, break him down, and then... 6-7 rounds, I think Floyd will get him up.
Mm, so you think Floyd actually stops him? A lot of people have that opinion, even though
absolutely.
He hasn't stopped a lot of opponents in the past.
Well, you know, but you know, when you know how to break a guy down, mm-hmm. with the experience of a Floyd Mayweather, you get him up.
Does that fight do bigger pay-per-view sales than Pac Mayweather? People are saying this might be the biggest fight of all time in the history of the sport.
Well, it may be because UFC has so many fans, and they're going to be the majority of buyers. So, it's a possibility it can do better than that.
Do you think boxing fans will pay for this pay-per-view and they'll support it?
I think some boxing fans will. I don't think the majority will, though.
What are you hearing in the back doors about this fight? You know, are people, like, scoffing at it? Because I know some people say, like, Andre Ward thinks it's good for the sport, that it brings a light to the sport, and, you know, anything that puts boxing on the forefront is good.
Oh, absolutely, and I agree with him. It does. It puts boxing in the forefront just because, you know, we can, look, Ali fought Inoki.
Mm-hmm. Yep. The Japanese, yep.
Yes. You know, Floyd fought a wrestler. Mm-hmm. You know, didn't count, but, you know, I mean, look, you know, anything that is a positive, I think it's a positive on the sport. It's not a negative like so many guys are talking who's trying to go up against it. You know, they talking the negative, but it's not. It's not a negative for the sport. Anytime you talk boxing, that's positive.
That's true. Well, last but not least, I want to get Ronnie Shields' top 5 pound-for-pound fighters in boxing.
Oh, man. Well, number one, I have to say Andre Ward.
Okay.
Number two, I would have to say Triple G.
Okay.
Number three, I would have to go with Anthony Joshua.
All right.
Number four, I would probably say Manny Pacquiao. And number five, I would have to say Terrence Crawford.
solid list right there. Appreciate your time.
All right, man.
We'll get that done.